Good evening. I am thrilled and honored to have the opportunity to perform for you this evening. This is a special sabbatical replacement year for me, teaching the piano studio of Joachim. Besides teaching, I listened to the suggestion of our chair, William Street, to do some performing as well. Convocation Hall holds a special place in my heart. The first time I performed in this hall was in 1972 when I was a young teenager studying with Ernesto Lajano, a piano prof at the UofA. It's okay, you can do the math. His love of opera, passion for music came through his teaching, and I owe a great debt to this marvelous man. 10 years later, when our son Mark was an infant, I premiered Alfred Fischer's fantasy pieces in this hall. Some of you present this evening heard the original premiere. 10 years later, in 1992, I was at the beginning of the DMUS degree and performed a number of recitals in this hall under the mentorship of Helmut Braus. Since then, it's been approximately 30 years since I performed a solo piano recital here. The program I chose for this evening is mostly a selection of familiar musical pieces. It begins with a great partita in E minor. This work has been a foundational piece for me since the Lajano days, but has changed through the years. One thing that remains constant is the improvisational character, particularly in the sarabande. Improvisation, tonal nuance, and imagination have been things I love about music, and particularly about how they work on the piano. The partita in E minor has taught me so much in my lifetime. The Mozart Sonata in C major, K330, is a work I've performed less often, but vividly remember the first time I heard it as a teenager. My dad was in the habit of playing records on our phonograph machine early in the morning. I was often awakened to Van Cliburn playing this sonata. A great way to start the day. The joy this piece exudes is palpable. It reminds me of opera with all its funny, but also tragic. The new work this evening, Reverie A.A. Vale, was composed by my good friend and mentor and colleague, Jacobus Kloppers, the first chair of music at the King's University. Kobe has written many pieces, including works for piano and organ duets for Marnie and I. I asked Kobe to write a piece for me in the style of a nocturne. Kobe went beyond this and remarks in the preface, "The work starts in a nocturnal mood, but evolves into something that evokes the image of daybreak and brightness." I think Kobe captured many of my moods and characters in this piece. The piece in rondo form is Liszt-ian in sound and technique, Scriabinesque in harmony, and whimsical and reflective with the typical Kobe-esque pedal tones in the soprano voice. Notice that the piece was written in 2018. I am finally playing it because live recitals are now possible, but also because I believe new works need a venue where people will be present at, and this is the time I'd like to premiere this work. I'm pleased to present this imaginative piece for you tonight. And I will be back to speak about Fischer after intermission, so enjoy the first half.
Thank you.
Alfred Fischer was a well-known pedagogue and composer who was active at the UofA Music Department during the 1980s, including being chair of the music department from 1986 till 1989. In those days, few pianists in Edmonton performed contemporary piano music, and Alfred asked me to premiere his fantasy pieces written for David Burge in 1982. I was pleased to premiere this work 40 years ago, and it's a real pleasure to play it again tonight. David Burge, a renowned pedagogue, pianist, author, and proponent of contemporary piano music, taught at the Easton School of Music for many years. He premiered the first book of George Crumb's Macrocosmos in the mid-1970s. In his book, 20th Century Piano Music, a major piano literature textbook for students today, he ranks Fischer's fantasy pieces among the strongest works written for piano in the last 20 years of the 20th century. According to Burge, they brilliantly express the perception of a passionate, serious, introspective human being. And by the way, I had the pleasure of attending the premiere of The Macrocosmos at Eastman when David Burge was performing it. These pieces also formed a major part of my written dissertation for the DMUS degree. And that dissertation was basically talking about performance analysis. And Catherine Noland, who was a brilliant theorist who taught here for a while, encouraged me to take a look at the theoretical principles and performance principles and write an essay on that, and that's what I did. It's been a joy relearning these pieces, and I will briefly describe each movement. Arik, the first one, is assertive and aggressive, filled with energetic forward movement. It's like having a heavy conversation with someone. Questions and answers, opinions listened to and rebutted in a musically humorous way. The second one, Reminiscences of Turandot. This is a sound piece full of color using all the pedals on the piano. Rich harmonic overtones are exploited with open rich harmonies like the Puccini opera. Why is it called Turandot? Listen carefully and you will hear a quotation from the aria Nessun Dorma. The third piece, There's My People Sleeping, in memory of Sirane Stump. Sirane Stump was an artist and a poet and a native North American. His eloquent There Is My People Sleeping suggested for Alfred Fischer new understanding of the art of narrative. It, I quote, it deepened and profoundly changed the notion of my people from the ethnocentric to the sacred, end of quote. Alfred combines musical narrative with a Jewish folk song. In two places, you will also hear percussive, repeated chords bringing a sense of lament and plea to wake up. If you listen carefully, this piece sounds like people from very different cultures and religious faiths listening to each other with deep respect and understanding about truth and reconciliation. The fourth piece, an etude of Chopin, is modeled on Opus 25, number 2. But instead of two groups of triplets, as in the Chopin etude, Fischer juxtaposed five notes to three in the left. Five notes in the right to three in the left. Quicksilver is less than 30 seconds in duration. It's similar to the second movement of Webern's piano variations for its brevity, humor, and pitch class trichord 1 or 0 1 6. Fallen Angel, the final movement, here the energy and the tension of the previous movements is entirely exhausted. It's a beautiful, colorful movement, but really, it can't end this recital. So I'm finishing this recital with the Chopin Ballade in G minor. Menahem Pressler taught me new ways to think about music in this particular ballade through a metaphor of tasting the harmonies.
Thank you.
I'd like to do a short improvisation by a tune you know, the words you know, by Cat Stevens, Morning Has Broken. And you can all use good news these days. And there's a new morning coming, and I'd like to...